تفضل يا شيخ، بارك الله فيكم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله
وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد، فأهلا وسهلا بكم أيها الإخوة والأخوات في هذا اللقاء العلمي الذي أحدثكم فيه من طيبة الطيبة من مدينة النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، مهبط الوحي ومأرز الإيمان. أحدثكم فيه عن موضوع مهم جدا ينبغي للمسلم أن يتنبه له بين حين وآخر، وإن استصحبه في عمره كله فحسن جدا. هذا الموضوع أيها الإخوة والأخوات هو موضوع الهداية وشكر الله سبحانه وتعالى عليها وأسباب الثبات عليها. نعم.
Our Shaykh Hafidhahu Allah Ta'ala, after greeting us with the salam, and he praised Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala and sent the salat and the salam upon the one who was sent as a mercy to all mankind, our beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and also upon his companions. He said, to proceed, I welcome all of you, my dear beloved brothers and sisters, in this meeting, which is ilmi, which were based on knowledge. So he said, therefore my talk to you from Taiba Taiba, the city of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the place that witnessed the revelation and the place of Iman when the Iman started, on a topic of extreme importance, he said. A topic of very extreme importance that is incumbent upon every Muslim to pay close attention to it time to time. But if a Muslim constantly think about this in all his lifespan, this is a very, very good thing to do. He said that topic, it is guidance. The fact that we are guided to Al-Islam, I'm thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon this guidance and the means that will help us to be firm upon this guidance. Naam ya Shaykh, sallallahu alayhi.
Ayyuha al-ikhwatu wal-akhawat, inna al-mutafakkira في نفسه وكيف أنعم الله سبحانه وتعالى عليه بالهداية للإسلام ليقف حائرا من هذا الاختيار الذي لا حول له فيه ولا قوة، فإن الله سبحانه وتعالى يختار للهداية لهذا الدين من يشاء سبحانه وتعالى، ويضل عن هذا الدين من يشاء سبحانه وتعالى. ولذلك فإن كل مسلم ليقف حائرا متفكرا، فإن شكر الله عز وجل على ذلك زاده الله عز وجل هدى، وإن غفل عن ذلك ربما تسلط عليه الشيطان فأخرجه من النور إلى الظلمات. كيف هذا أيها الإخوة والأخوات؟ نحن نرى ونقرأ عن أقوام كانوا أقرب الناس نسبا للأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام، وأقرب الناس مكانا للأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام، وأقرب الناس زمانا للأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام. ومع هذا دلت نصوص الكتاب والسنة على أنهم من رؤوس الضلال والكفر، وأنهم خالدون في النار والعياذ بالله. ثم نرى معاشر الأحبة أناسا بعيدين زمانا ومكانا ونسبا عن الأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام، ونرى أن الله عز وجل قد شاء لهم الهداية ورحمهم سبحانه وتعالى ووفقهم سبحانه وتعالى وسلك بهم سبيل الأئمة الصالحين الذين قبلوا هذا الدين وانقادوا له، وبالتالي كتب الله لهم السعادة في الدنيا وفي الآخرة. فما هو السبب أيها الأحبة في هذا كله؟ نعم
الشيخ حفظه الله تعالى continue by saying, my dear beloved brothers and sisters, indeed the one who reflects carefully upon himself and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala conferred upon him this great favor that by guiding him to Al-Islam, certainly a person like this will be puzzled. And for the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide him to something that he knows he has no power, he has nothing to do with it whatsoever. That's because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses to guide to this deen whom he wills. And he turns others away from being guided from this deen. He said, for these things and for these reasons, every Muslim should actually contemplate and reflect upon this. He said, so therefore, if he, while doing this, if he thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon this guidance and for this guidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase him in this guidance. And if he is negligent and heedless, perhaps the shaitan may play tricks on that person and therefore take him out from light of guidance to the darknesses. How could this be possible? The Shaykh said, we all know and we read about people who in the past, they used to be the closest to the prophets as related to lineage. They're the closest to them as related to the place where those prophets they lived in, and they are the closest to them as related to the time. Some of them they were contemporary and they live in the same time of the prophets. And with all this, there is so many texts from the Quran and the Sunnah that shows to us clearly that these people, not only that they were not guided, but actually they were the leaders in misguidance and disbelief. And so therefore they are to be from among the dwellers of the hellfire. And in the same way, in the same time, we know and we heard and we read about other people who they are far away from the times of the prophets. They are far away from the place, they never lived in the places where the prophets were. They have no connections whatsoever to the prophets as related to their lineage. And in the same time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed for them the guidance. Allah had mercy upon them and made them successful to be upon this guidance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them to be and to follow the path of the leaders, the imams, of the righteous, those who accept this deen and they comply to its teachings. So therefore, they earn the happiness in this life and the hereafter. He says, so now the question is, what is the reason behind all this? Naam ya Shaykh, sallallahu alayhi.
وإن المتفكر أيها الإخوة والأخوات في جواب هذا الأمر لا يجد إلا جوابا واحدا لا ثاني له أبدا، وهو أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أراد أن يخلق لهذه الجنة التي خلقها وزينها وملأها بأنواع الطيبات، أراد أن يخلق لها أهلا، فتفضل على أقوام من بني آدم فهداهم لهذا الدين قديما وحديثا حتى يدخلهم الجنة فضلا منه سبحانه وتعالى وكرما منه سبحانه وتعالى، لا بحول أحد أبدا ولا بقوة أحد أبدا، ولا بذكاء أحد أبدا، إنما ذلك كله محض فضل الله عز وجل. ولذلك أخي الموفق، أختي الموفقة، أخي المهتدي لهذا الدين، أختي المهتدية لهذا الدين، اعلموا ثبتني الله وإياكم على هذا الدين، أن الهداية هدية من الله عز وجل لنا ولكم. والله لا بحولنا هدينا، ولا بقوتنا هدينا، ولا بذكائنا هدينا، ولا بآبائنا ولا أمهاتنا، ولا بنسبنا ولا حسبنا ولا لوننا. إنما خلق الله عز وجل خلقا فقال هؤلاء للجنة ولا أبالي. ولذلك قال الله عز وجل إنا هديناه السبيل إما شاكرا وإما كفورا. وقال سبحانه وتعالى في بيان منته سبحانه وتعالى على عباده بالهداية الذي أعطى كل شيء خلقه ثم هدى، وقال سبحانه وتعالى كذلك في بيان فضله سبحانه وتعالى على عباده بالهداية، قال في أول سورة أنزلت اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق، خلق الإنسان من علق، اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم، علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. نعم.
The Shaykh Hafidh Allah Ta'ala, he said, indeed, the one who reflects carefully upon the answer to this question, he will never, never find more than one single answer to this question. There is no other answer for this question. There is only one. That is, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, he, from his hikmah and wisdom, he created for this Jannah, for the paradise, this paradise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created and has beautified and has put in it all types and kinds of pure things and beautiful things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for it people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conferred upon certain people from the children of Adam by guiding them in the previous times and the latter time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala conferred upon them this great ni'mah, and he guide them and therefore allow them to enter al-Jannah out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of him being generous to them. Not because of their might, of their strength, or their intellect, or the like. Rather, this is only because of Allah's bounty upon them. He said, so therefore, my brother who is being made successful by Allah, my beloved sister, that Allah has made you successful, my brother, that Allah has guided you, my beloved sister, that Allah has guided you, you should all know. He said, all know, may Allah give us firmness upon this deen, us and you, that guidance is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To be guided to this deen of Islam is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us and for you. The Shaykh said, by Allah, it is not due to our strength, not due to our might, not due to our intellect. It's not because of who our parents are. It's not because who our mothers are. It's not because of our lineage. It's not because of our skin color that we are guided to this, to Islam. Rather, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created a group of people, and he said, these they will be in the Jannah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained to us in the Quran, when he said, indeed, we have guide this man, the mankind, to the path of success, yet some of them are thankful and some of them they disbelieve in this ni'mah. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in another verse reminding us of his ni'mah and the ni'mah upon his servants by guiding them to the path of righteousness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it is he, Allah, who has given this this creature all what they need, and then he guide them. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made clear to us his fadl and his virtue upon his servants by guiding them to be upon the truth and upon the path, upon the Islam. He said, in the first surah that was revealed to the Prophet ﷺ, Surah Iqra, Bismi Rabbika Alladhi Khalaq, read in the name of your Lord. And the Mashaykh, he mentioned those three or four ayahs in the beginning of the surah. Naam ya Shaykh, sallallahu alayhi.
ولذلك إذا دخل أهل الجنة الجنة قالوا الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله، لأنهم علموا أن مسيرهم في الحياة الدنيا ومسيرهم في دار البرزخ ومسيرهم يوم القيامة في ذلك اليوم العظيم ونجاتهم من النار وهدايتهم على الصراط ودخولهم الجنة، كل هذه الأمور العظام خارجة عن مقدور بني آدم. فوالله لولا أن هدى الله عز وجل من شاء من خلقه لهذا الخير العظيم ما استطاع أحد بحوله ولا قوته أن يهتدي. ولذلك أقروا لله سبحانه وتعالى بالفضل فقالوا الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله، لأن هذه الهداية محض فضل الله عز وجل. ولذلك كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والصحابة يرددون رجزا، والله لولا الله ما اهتدينا وما تصدقنا وما صلينا. نعم أيها الأحبة في الله، لأن الله عز وجل يقول فمن يرد الله أن يهديه يشرح صدره للإسلام. بعد أن كانت قلوبنا مغلقة عن قبول الحق، من الذي شرحها؟ لا شك إن الذي شرحها هو الذي خلقها وهو الذي فطرها وهو الذي أوجدها من العدم. فمن يرد الله أن يهديه يشرح صدره للإسلام، ومن يرد أن يضله يجعل صدره ضيقا حرجا كأنما يصعد في السماء. فنحمد الله سبحانه وتعالى على هذه الهداية. ولذلك يقول ابن القيم رحمه الله إن التفكر في اسم الله عز وجل الأول يرشد إلى أمور عظيمة، فهو سبحانه وتعالى أول كان ولم يكن شيء قبله، أو كان ولم يكن شيء معه، كان الله عز وجل وما كنت. يقول الله عز وجل هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. فلما كنت في مرحلة العدم كان الله عز وجل موجودا، فخلقك سبحانه وتعالى بفضله ومنته وكرمه، وصورك فأحسن صورتك، وجعل لك عينين ولسانا وشفتين، وهداك سبحانه وتعالى النجدين، كل هذا بلا حول منك ولا قوة، ثم أخرجك إلى هذه الحياة الدنيا وهداك إلى هذا الدين الذي أضل عنه أقواما كثيرين، كل هذا بلا حول منك ولا قوة. فاسأله سبحانه وتعالى باسمه الأول، قل يا أول، يا من كنت موجودا عندما كنت معدوما وهديتني لهذا الدين بلا حول مني ولا قوة، أسألك أن تثبتني عليه. انتهى كلام ابن القيم رحمه الله بمعناه. نعم.
So the Shaykh Hafidahullah Ta'ala continued by saying so for this, when the people of the Jannah, they will enter Al-Jannah, they will say all praises to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala who had guided us to this. Had it not been for Allah's guidance to us, we will never be guided to this. The Shaykh said that because they have certain knowledge, they know with certainty that the person while in the dunya and on the barzakh and on Yawm al-Qiyamah, and also his safety, that this person's safety from the fire, and the fact that he was guided to pass through the Sirat, to the bridge, and therefore enter the Jannah. All this, a person has no ability whatsoever to achieve all this by himself. The Shaykh said, Wallahi, by Allah, had it not been for the favors of Allah upon his servants, they will never, none of them, will be guided to this great deal of good, as we mentioned. He said, rather, this is only due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mercy upon his servants and his favor that he has conferred upon them. For this reason, they know this. They said, all praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who guide us to this. And had it not been for the fact that Allah guide us to it, we will never be guided. That because, once again, remember that being guided is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the people are guided only due to Allah's mercy upon them. He said, for this reason, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, they used to say and repeat constantly these statements, by Allah, had it not been for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will never be guided. We will never give anything in charity. And had it not been for Allah's guidance upon us, we will never pray. So the Shaykh said, yes. Yes, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran al-Kareem, for those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants guidance for them, He will open their chests to Islam. Yes, Ya Akhwan, He said, yes, our hearts were closed from accepting the truth. Who has opened our hearts to the truth? Who has opened our hearts before they were closed? He said, no doubt whatsoever, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, our Creator, our Lord, who has created us and guide us. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the ayah, whosoever Allah wants guidance for him, he will open their chest to Islam. And for the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will lead them astray, he will make their chest tight as though they are ascending in the heavens. The Shaykh, hafidhahu Allah ta'ala, said, Naam, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has conferred upon us this great ni'mah and great favor of guidance. And he mentioned a statement of Ibn Qayyim rahimahullahu ta'ala, who said, indeed, reflecting upon the name of Allah, His first name, Al-Awwal, will lead you to many, many good things. From them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala existed before anything exists, before you exist, no one was with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, at the time when you didn't exist, Allah existed. He said, and he mentioned the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, is it a time that come upon the children of Adam when he was nothing before? He was nothing. There is no mention for him whatsoever. He said, so therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you out of his karam, out of his mercy and out of his bounty upon you. He has created you. He has fashioned you in the best of forms. And he has given you and made for you eyes, a tongue, and he has guided you to the path of righteousness. All this without any strength from you. It's not due to your intellect, to your strength or the like. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought you into this dunya and guided you to this deen, to this upright deen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made many, many other groups of people to be misguided and to stay away from this deen. All this happened, and yet you have nothing to do with it. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His first name, Al-Awwal. Say, O Allah, Ya Awwal, the one who exists while I have no existence. O Allah, guided me to the path. O Allah, keep me firm on the path and likewise. Naam ya Shaykh, sallallahu alayhi.
وهذه الهداية لها أسباب كي يثبت العبد عليها حتى يلقى الله سبحانه وتعالى. وهذه الأمور لا يمكن أن يقوم بها الإنسان إلا بإعانة الله سبحانه وتعالى. فالهداية فضل منه سبحانه وتعالى، واستمرارها فضل منه سبحانه وتعالى وإعانة منه سبحانه وتعالى. فالكل منه سبحانه وتعالى أولا وآخرا، فهو الذي يهدي سبحانه وتعالى وهو الذي يثبت، ولكن هذا الثبات مرتبط بأسباب، فإذا أتى العبد بها ثبته الله عز وجل بإذنه، وإذا تركها العبد كانت الأخرى والعياذ بالله. أول سبب من هذه الأسباب معاشر الأحبة العلم الشرعي بهذا الدين جملة وتفصيلا. من أراد أن يثبته الله عز وجل على هذا الدين، من أراد أن ينفع الإسلام والمسلمين وأن يثبت الله عز وجل الإسلام في قلبه وفي بلده وفي أمته بل في الدنيا كلها، فعليه بهذا العلم، لأن الناس معاشر الأحبة أعداء لما جهلوا. فإذا تعلم الإنسان دينه وعرف محاسنه وعرف أثره عليه وعلى أهله وعلى ماله وعلى مجتمعه، تمسك بهذا الدين الذي لا صلاح لأمر دينه ودنياه إلا به. ولذلك الله عز وجل يقول: وكذلك أوحينا إليك روحا من أمرنا ما كنت تدري ما الكتاب ولا الإيمان ولكن جعلناه نورا نهدي به من نشاء من عبادنا وإنك لتهدي إلى صراط مستقيم. فإذا معاشر الأحبة، أولا علينا بهذا العلم. نعم.
The Shaykh حفظ الله تعالى continued by saying, he said, and this guidance has many means that if a person followed them, he will have a firm foot upon it. So another person, if he wants to be firm upon this guidance until he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has to know these things and he has to follow them. And he should know that a person will only be firm upon this if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aided him and assisted him. Remember, he said once again, as we mentioned, that guidance is a fadl from Allah, is a virtue from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon his servants. And to continue upon this guidance is as well a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is only due to Allah's assistance and help for that person to be continuous upon this guidance. So everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing from anybody else. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who guides, and it is He as well who keep people firm upon this guidance. He said, but being firm upon this guidance has many means. If a person follow them, have knowledge of them and follow them and apply them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him firmness. But if a person neglect about them, he doesn't know these means, and he therefore he could never be able to act upon them, so he won't have no firmness upon this guidance. He said the number one of these means that will allow the person to be firm upon this guidance is having knowledge of this deen of al-Islam. Having this legislative knowledge of this deen of al-Islam in its details, in general and in details. The Shaykh says, so therefore, whoever desires firmness upon this deen and he wants to benefit from Islam and benefit Islam and the Muslims, if a person wants Islam to be firmly established in his heart, in his family, in his country, in the area he lives and in the whole of the earth, there is no other way except through knowledge of this deen of Islam. He said, you should know that the people, they always enemy to that which they don't have knowledge of. Those who don't know certain things, they are enemies to it, and therefore they won't benefit from it. But on the other hand, if a person learn his deen, and that knowledge will allow him to know the beauty of this deen, and so therefore he will realize the impact of this deen upon his soul and upon his family members, upon his wealth, upon his community, no doubt a person he will hold on firm to it, because he knows that there is that his deen and his dunya will never be rectified without this deen of Islam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Likewise, we have revealed to you a ruh from our commands. You have no knowledge of the book or iman. Rather, we have made it a light. Through it, we guide whom we will from our servants. And indeed, you, O Muhammad, you guide to a path that is straight. So the Shaykh, he said, so therefore the first things from the means that will keep us firm upon this guidance is that we have to learn the knowledge of the legislation. Naam ya Shaykh, sallallahu alayhi.
Al-amru al-thani, an yakuna ilmuka ala sunnah, lianna الأدعياء كثيرون. والعلم إذا لم يكن على السنة صار وبالا على صاحبه. ولذلك لما كثر أدعياء العلم وكثر دعاة البدعة تفرقت الأمة، وما ازدادت الأمة بهم إلا بلاء، وما ازداد الناس بهم إلا ضلالا. ولذلك أخي الفاضل، لا بد أن تحرص على أن يكون علمك وفق كتاب الله عز وجل وسنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأن تفهمهما كما فهمهما السلف الصالح، الصحابة رضي الله عنهم والتابعون لهم بإحسان. ولذلك تعتني بآثار الصحابة والتابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان. والآيات على هذا كثيرة جدا. قال الله عز وجل: والسابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان. فنحن لسنا من السابقين ولسنا من الأنصار، فما بقي لتحقيق رضوان الله عز وجل إلا مرتبة الاتباع، فاحرص عليها. وقال الله عز وجل: فمن اتبع هدايا فلا يضل ولا يشقى، ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا، ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى. قال رب لم حشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا؟ قال: كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى. قال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما: تكفل الله بمن قرأ القرآن وعمل بما فيه ألا يضل في الدنيا ولا يشقى في الآخرة. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول في الحديث المشهور: تركت فيكم ما إن تمسكتم بهما لن تضلوا بعدي أبدا، كتاب الله وسنتي.
الشيخ حفظ الله تعالى, he mentioned the second means that keep the people firm upon this guidance of Islam, and that is that your knowledge has to be upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not just to acquire knowledge, but that knowledge has to be upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said that because, as you know, there is many callers these days, and knowledge, if it's not conformed to the sunnah, therefore it will be a problem upon his, that person who has that knowledge. He says, so therefore we all know that there is so many callers that call to knowledge, there is many callers that call to innovations, so therefore the ummah become divided. And this ummah and the community of the Muslims, they become weak and increase in trials, and the people, they increase in misguidance. So therefore he said, my noble brother, be diligent that your knowledge has to be in accordance to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you should understand the text of the book and the sunnah as were understood by the Salaf al-Salih, which are the companions and those who follow them upon that good. So therefore we have to, he said, take good care of the narrations of the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim, the companions, and those who follow them upon their good. He said the ayats are many to support this point. He mentioned from them the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the foremost amongst the muhajireen and the ansar who has accepted Islam, and those who follow them with good, and those who follow them with good. He said, the Shaykh, he said, so you know for sure that me and you and all of us, we are not from those foremost people who accept Islam. We are not from the muhajireen and we are not from the ansar. What is left for us? That third level mentioned in this ayah, to be from the people who follow these two. To be from the people who follow. So therefore he said, be diligent and be conscious to be among these people who follow the path of the muhajireen and the ansar. Also he mentioned the other ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whosoever follow my guidance, he will never go astray and he will never witness any hardship. And as for those who turn away from my remembrance, it is for him a life of hardship. And on the day of a judgment, we will resurrect him blind. He will say, my Lord, how comes that you resurrected me blind and I used to see before? And it will be said to him, likewise, our proofs, revelation and text has come to you, and you turn away from them and forget about them. So these days, this day you will be forgotten. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guaranteed for the one who recites the Quran and acts upon it that he will never go astray in the dunya and he will never witness any hardship of any kind in the akhirah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned to us in this very known and famous hadith, illustrate his point by mentioning, I have left amongst you two things. If you hold on firm to them, you will never go astray. You will never be misguided, the Book of Allah and my Sunnah. Naam ya Shaykh, sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. Thumma la budda an yakuna lahu barnamijun ilmiyun مرتب فيبدأ المسلم بالأهم فالمهم لأن البداءة بعلم المعتقد الذي بدأ به الأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام هو من أعظم أسباب الهداية والثبات عليها. ولذلك يقول الله عز وجل ولقد بعثنا في كل أمة رسولا أن اعبدوا الله واجتنبوا الطاغوت فمنهم من هدى ومنهم من حقت عليه الضلالة. ويقول الله تبارك وتعالى يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ويضل الله الظالمين ويفعل الله ما يشاء. فإذا حقق العبد توحيد الله عز وجل وبدأ بعلم العقيدة والتوحيد والإيمان والسنة فإن ذلك من أعظم أسباب الهداية والثبات عليها.
الشيخ حفظه الله تعالى continue by saying, so therefore, since we're talking about knowledge, he said, it is very suitable for a person to have a schedule, to have a well-determined schedule of studying this deen. And he should begin with that which is more important and that which is important and likewise. He said that is the most important thing that the Muslims should begin with and studying is the issues of belief and creed. Because this is the first topic that the prophets they began with. And so therefore, if you do this, if you began with that which the prophets they began with, and to study the affairs of the belief and aqidah and creed, this is one of the great things that not only keep you guided, but that it give you firmness upon the path of guidance. He says, for this reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, indeed we have sent amongst every nation a messenger saying to his people, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and avoid the taghut. So therefore, amongst those people, amongst them, those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided to the path, and others, misguidance was prescribed upon them. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in another verse, it is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who grants firmness upon this guidance to those who believe in this life and in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused the zalimun, the wrongdoers and the criminals, to be misguided. And Allah does what He wills. So He says, so therefore, if the servant fulfill this point, and so therefore he take good care of learning the Tawheed, and he begun by studying the affairs of Aqeedah and Creed and Tawheed, Iman and the Sunnah, no doubt, if he does this, he put himself on one of the greatest means that will make him guided and also give him firmness upon that guidance. Naam, Sheikh.
ثم بعد ذلك معاشر الأحبة يحرص المسلم كل الحرص على العمل بهذا العلم الذي تعلمه وأن يكون علمه وعمله خالصا لله عز وجل فكما تعلم لله عز وجل يجب عليه أن يعمل لله عز وجل وكما حرص على تحصيل العلم كذلك يحرص على تحقيق العمل فكما ذكر بعض السلف هتف العلم بالعمل فإن وجده وإلا ارتحل ولذلك من أعظم أسباب الهداية العمل بهذا العلم من أعظم أسباب الثبات على الهداية العمل بهذا العلم فإن كان العمل واجبا وجب أن نعمل به وكان في تركه إثما عظيما وإن كان العمل من المستحبات كان يستحب لنا أن نعمل به فالعمل به زيادة في الإيمان وزيادة الإيمان من أعظم أسباب الثبات وكلنا يعرف حديث الولي الذي قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن ربه عز وجل من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب وما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه إذن أول ما تبدأ بفعل الواجبات ثم الإكثار من النوافل تنال محبة الله عز وجل وإذا وصلت إلى هذه المرتبة كان هذا من أعظم أسباب الهداية والثبات عليها كما قال ربنا عز وجل والذين جاهدوا فينا لنهدينهم سبلنا وقال الله عز وجل يهدي به الله من اتبع رضوانه سبل السلام ويخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور ويهديهم إلى صراط مستقيم والاتباع إنما يكون بالعمل لا بمجرد الكلام كما قال الله عز وجل في آية الامتحان والابتلاء قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحبكم الله نعم.
And the Shaykh Hafidah Allah Ta'ala continued by saying, and then after this, the Muslim should be diligent into acting upon that knowledge. Once he learned, he has to put that knowledge into action. He said that because knowledge mandates actions. He said, and his knowledge, likewise, his actions has to be sincerely for Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Likewise, before he learned, he has to learn only for the sake of Allah. It is incumbent upon him to act upon that knowledge only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Said likewise, he was so diligent into learning about the deen, he should be more diligent now to act upon that which he has learned. He said, as some of the Salaf, they mentioned that knowledge always call upon actions. If a person does not act upon that which he know, he will forget that knowledge, and that knowledge will go away. So therefore, acting upon that which you know, it is from the great means that keep you firm upon guidance. He said, so therefore, now the Shaykh brings some details. He said, so therefore, if that which you have learned, and so therefore the actions is fall on the category of that which is obligatory upon you, so therefore you should know that it's obligatory upon you to act upon that. Otherwise, if you leave it off, therefore you are a sinner and you commit a sin. If the action is from the supererogatory actions of worship, so therefore it is recommended for us and desirable for us to act upon it. And if we do so, it will increase us in iman. And we all know that being increased in iman is from the great means that keep us firm upon guidance. He said, no doubt we all know the famous hadith of the wali, where the Prophet ﷺ mentioned to us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he who show enmity to one of my wali, the people who they are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wage war against them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that my servant will never get closer to me with anything except for that which I have made obligatory upon him. And my servant will continue to increase in onto doing actions of nawafil, the supererogatory actions of worship, until I love him, to the end of the hadith. But the Shaykh stops over here, he says, until I love him. So therefore, first of all, you should act upon that which Allah has made obligatory upon you. Fulfill your obligations first, preserve them. And then increase from the supererogatory acts of worship. This will allow you to be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will love you. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love you, you should know that this is one of the greatest signs that you are upon guidance and that you are firm upon it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, indeed those who they strive hard to be upon that which we has commanded them with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them to be firm upon that guidance. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said another ayah, that this revelation, Allah guide through it those who follow his pleasure and the means of the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that because through that knowledge he takes them out from the darknesses to the light, from the darknesses to the light. And the Shaykh Hafidhahullah ta'ala, he said, and benefiting from knowledge is through action, not just through talking about. If you want to really benefit from knowledge, is through putting that knowledge to action, not just talk about knowledge all the time. He said, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has clearly mentioned to us in this ayah, 31 in Surah Ali Imran, said, where the ulama, they mention and refer to it as the verse of test, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to them, if you really love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then follow me. نعم يا شيخ صلى الله عليه.
ومن أعظم أسباب الهداية والثبات عليها حماية هذه الهداية التي امتن الله سبحانه وتعالى بها علينا من عدوين خطيرين جدا يروج لهما إبليس وجنوده، ألا وهما مرض الشهوات والشبهات. فعلى المسلم الذي رزقه الله عز وجل الهداية أن يحمي نفسه من هذه الشبهات الفكرية التي يلقيها أعداء الإسلام أو أعداء السنة، وليشكر الله عز وجل على الهداية، وليتمسك باليقين الثابت من كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وليبتعد عما أحدثه أهل البدع من كلام وشبهات حول الدين أو حول السنة، وكذلك أن يحمي نفسه من هذه الشهوات وأن يحمي نفسه من اتباع خطوات الشيطان، وأن يحمي نفسه من كل مدخل من مداخل الشيطان، سواء من مدخل القلب أو من مدخل العينين أو من مدخل الأذنين. يحمي نفسه كما قال ربنا عز وجل: إن السمع والبصر والفؤاد كل أولئك كان عنه مسؤولا. وقال سبحانه: وإما ينزغنك من الشيطان نزغ فاستعذ بالله. ومن أعظم أسباب الحماية من هذه الأمراض الاستعانة بالله عز وجل والاستعاذة به سبحانه وتعالى من شر الشيطان. فإن أكثر من ضل من عباد الله بسبب هذين المرضين: إما مسلم ظاهره الصلاح ظل في مرض الشبهات، وإما مسلم ظل والعياذ بالله في مرض الشهوات. ولذلك ينبغي على المسلم أن يحمي نفسه من هذين المرضين كما يحمي نفسه من الأمراض البدنية الخطيرة.
الشيخ حفظه الله تعالى continue by saying: and from the greatest means that keep a person firm upon guidance is that once he is guided, he has to protect his guidance. He has to protect it. So since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conferred upon you this guidance, you have to protect it from two extreme, very dangerous enemies. These two enemies, the shaitan constantly promote their danger. And these two enemies is the sickness that comes from shahawat, following desires, and the sickness and the illness that come from following shubuhat, doubtful matters. Shahawat and shubuhat. He says, so therefore the Muslim whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conferred upon him guidance, he has to protect himself from shubuhat, from doubtful things, from things that is cast by the enemies of Islam, or from the enemies of the Sunnah. They may be Muslims, and from the enemies of the Sunnah they cast statements and they propagate statements and the like, which they are poisonous. And he has to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for being guided, and to hold on firm to this guidance. And he has to be sure and certain that he is upon guidance, and he should stay away from the statements of the people of innovations who talks about the deen of Islam and talks about and against the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Likewise, a person who is guided, he has to protect himself from falling into shahawat, from falling into lust and desires, by following the footsteps of the shaitan. He said he has to try to close down every gate and every open that the shaitan may try to open for him, whether through the heart or the eyes or the ears. The Shaykh, he said, protect yourself. Protect and preserve your guidance. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, indeed, the hearing, the sight, and the heart, all of this flesh, all of these bounties you will be asked about. And also in another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and when the shaitan tried to whisper to you, seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the accursed shaitan. So the Shaykh said, it is indeed from the greatest things that will give you firmness upon and this guidance and keep you firm upon it, is that you have to protect yourself from these fatal diseases and illnesses. And this could be achieved through seeking refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil of the shaitan. From the evil of the shaitan. He said, many are the people who are misguided. They are misguided because of these two extreme dangerous things: shahawat and shubuhat, lust and desires and doubtful things. He said, sometimes you find a Muslim, the outside of that person, apparently he look a righteous person, but actually he may be misguided because him following shubuhat, doubtful matters.
This audio file has been distributed by salafitapes.com.
And likewise, by looking at a Muslim, just by looking at him, the outside image of that person may give you an idea how righteous he may be, But in reality, he may be a person who is misguided because he follows his lusts and desires. So he said, it is incumbent upon all of us to protect ourselves. Those amongst us whom Allah guide us upon the truth, it is incumbent upon us to protect ourselves from these two extreme enemies upon us. And we should be more diligent in to fight them, more so that we fight those diseases that they may attack our physics and the like. Naam, ya Shaykh.
كيف الوقت يا شيخ؟
الساعة ماذا ساعة الآن يا شيخ؟
يكفيكم بقى عندي ثلاث نقاط إذا شئتم إياها ولا خلاص؟
تفضل يا شيخ ما زال عندنا نصف ساعة قبل صلاة العصر إن شاء الله.
طيب.
تفضل الله يبارك فيك.
ثم حفظكم الله ورعاكم أمر مهم جدا من أسباب الثبات على الهداية وهو الحرص على الأخلاق الإسلامية، فعلى المسلم أن يحرص على الأخلاق التي شرعها لنا الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم، فإن ذلك من أعظم أسباب الثبات. ولنضرب مثلا حفظكم الله بخلقين مباركين. الخلق الأول الصدق، يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عليكم بالصدق فإن الصدق يهدي إلى البر وإن البر يهدي إلى الجنة، ولا يزال الرجل يصدق ويتحرى الصدق حتى يكتب عند الله صديقا. والخلق الثاني خلق الحياء، فإن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول الحياء من الإيمان، ويقول صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الحياء لا يأتي إلا بخير. فمن التزم الأخلاق الإسلامية الفاضلة وابتعد عن الأخلاق الرديئة ثبته الله عز وجل على هذا الدين كما مر معنا.
الشيخ حفظه الله تعالى, after he requires how much time we have, we said alhamdulillah we still have some time, and he says so therefore we have three more points, and he says so therefore may Allah preserve all of you. This is a great, one of the most important means that keep us firm upon this guidance, is that we should be diligent into applying and adorning ourselves with the ethics and the manners of Islam, to adorn ourselves with the etiquettes and the good manners of Islam, these manners that was legislated to us by Allah and by His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Shaykh said, and we give you an example of two blessed etiquettes from the edicts of Islam. Number one, said truthfulness. He said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, be truthful. Indeed, a person who try to be truthful and continue to speak the truth and act upon it, indeed this truthfulness lead to birr. And this word birr encompasses all types of good, and this birr will lead to the Jannah. He said, and a person will continue to be truthful and speak the truth and act upon it until he will be written with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a Siddiq, as a truthful. The second good manner from Al-Islam is Al-Haya, shyness. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Haya, shyness, it is from Iman, it is from faith. In another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, shyness doesn't bring nothing but good. Shyness, Haya, doesn't bring anything but good. So the Shaykh said, so therefore, he who restricts himself to the manners and the etiquettes of Al-Islam, to the excellent morals of Al-Islam, and stay away from the despicable, wicked acts, indeed, this is from the greatest things that keep that person firm upon the deen of Islam and upon guidance. Naam, ya Shaykh.
من أسباب الثبات على الدين أحبتي في الله التوبة. والتوبة حفظكم الله تتضمن ترك المعصية والندم على فعلها ومعاهدة الله عز وجل وحده على عدم العود إليها. ولأن الإنسان في مسيره لا بد أن يخطي, لأن الخطأ شيء كتبه الله عز وجل في أصل خلقتنا, كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كل ابن آدم خطأ وخير الخطائين التوابون. وأبشركم برب غفور رحيم يقبل توبة عباده سبحانه وتعالى، يبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار، ويبسط يده بالنهار ليتوب مسيء الليل. نشكره سبحانه وتعالى على هذا، ونسأله أن يتوب علينا. والآيات في فضل التوبة والأحاديث كثيرة جدا معلومة لديكم. نعم.
الشيخ حفظه تعالى he said another, he mentioned another mean from the means that keep us firm upon guidance, which is tawbah, repentance, and turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, and this tawbah comprises what? Leaving off the sin first. Leaving off the sin and feeling the grief and the sorrow by acting upon that sin, and to promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, to promise Allah that you will never go back to that sin. That's what consists of a tawbah. He said, so therefore that because, he said, being a human being, and through your life, you're going to make mistakes. This is only natural. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is how Allah created us, the Shaykh said. We will make mistakes. But here is the good news, he said, the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he says, all the children of Adam make mistakes, but the best of all those who err and wrong themselves are those who turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance, by repenting from their sins. The Shaykh Hafidhullah Ta'ala said, my dear beloved ones, I'm giving you this good news and reminding, actually bringing you a reminder of this good news, that our Lord is a Lord who is Ghafoor Rahim. He forgives and He is merciful. Our Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He accepted tawbah, repentance from His servants, and He forgives much of their sins. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, who extend His hand in the daytime, so those who sin at night time to ask for forgiveness. And it is He, our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who extend His hand in the night time, so those who err and wrong themselves in the daytime ask for forgiveness. He said, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all this, and we ask Him to forgive our sins and to make us from those who often turn in repentance to Him. The Shaykh said, indeed the ayats and the text from the Sunnah are many as related to the Tawbah, and he said, and they are well known to all of you. Naam ya Shaykh sallallahu alayhi.
النقطة الأخيرة أحبتي في الله، إخواني وأخواتي في الله، بعد أن ذاق المؤمن حلاوة الإيمان، وبعد أن فرح بفضل الله عز وجل عليه ونعمته، يجب عليه أن يخاف أن يعود إلى الكفر مرة أخرى، لأنه إذا عاد إلى الكفر مرة أخرى عاد إلى الظلمات، والظلمات تهديه إلى النار والعياذ بالله. ولذلك عليه أن يكثر من الدعاء، أن يدعو الله عز وجل الذي هداه وتفضل عليه وأنعم عليه وأنار قلبه وأنار بصيرته وأنار عقله، أن يثبته على هذا الدين. ولذلك كان أكثر دعاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم يا مقلب القلوب والأبصار ثبت قلبي على دينك. تقول له بعض أمهات المؤمنين، كيف تقول هذا يا رسول الله؟ قال نعم، إن قلوب بني آدم بين أصبعين من أصابع الرحمن يقلبها كيف يشاء. فنحن نسأل الله عز وجل رب جبرائيل وميكائيل وإسرافيل، فاطر السماوات والأرض، عالم الغيب والشهادة، الذي يهدي عباده إلى ما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنه، أن يهدينا إلى ما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنه، إنه يهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. ونسأله سبحانه وتعالى الذي قلوبنا بين أصبعين من أصابعه أن يثبتنا على هذا الدين، وأن يميتنا على الإيمان، وأن يحشرنا مع المؤمنين، مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين، وحسن أولئك رفيقا. والله أعلى وأعلم، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Our beloved Shaykh Hafidhullah Ta'ala, he said the last point he wants to mention today from the means that keep one's firm upon guidance and upon the deen of Al-Islam, said, my dear beloved brothers and sisters, he said, after Allah has made you to taste the sweetness of Iman, Allah made you to taste the sweetness of Iman in your hearts, and Allah made you happy by conferring upon you this ni'mah of guidance. So therefore it is incumbent upon you to be afraid that you may go back to disbelief another time. After tasting the sweetness of Iman, you should be afraid of doing something that may cost you to go back to that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved you from and take you out from. He said that because if a person go back to that, to those darknesses, that may lead him to go to the fire wal-iyadu billah, and we seek refuge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from that. So he said, so therefore, a person like this who is afraid from turning back to kufr and disbelief, he should increase from supplications and invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Invoke the one who guided you. Invoke the one who has conferred upon you this great ni'mah. Invoke the one who has put some light in your heart and a light in your sight and in your intellect. Invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you firmness upon this deen. That's why he said, from the dua and the supplication that the Prophet ﷺ used to repeat most often is this one. O you the one who caused the hearts and the sights to be turned, keep my heart firm upon your guidance or remembrance. So therefore, since this is the case for the Prophet ﷺ, and he is constantly repeating this dua, one of his wives, the wives of the Prophet ﷺ, which are the mothers of the believers, she said to the Prophet ﷺ, she was amazed, you are the messenger of Allah, and how could it be possible for you to ask such, to make such supplication? The Prophet ﷺ said to her, indeed, that because the hearts are between the two fingers from the fingers of Ar-Rahman, the Most Merciful, he turned them as he wished. So the Shaykh said, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of Jibreel and Mika'il and Israfil, the one who the originator of the heavens and the earth, the one who has knowledge of the unseen, to guide us to that which the people, they differ among themselves. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us upon the straight path. And the Shaykh said, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who our hearts are between two fingers of his fingers, to keep us firm upon this deen, and to keep us firm upon this guidance. And he said, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the iman, and to allow us to die upon the iman, and therefore to make us to be resurrected among those people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conferred upon them his favors, among the prophets, among the righteous, the martyrs. And how excellent indeed to be in the company of these. And the Shaykh, he has concluded his talk. جزاكم الله خيرا فضيلة الشيخ. ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يحفظكم وأن يزيدكم علما وأن يثبتنا وإياكم على الحق حتى يأتينا اليقين. ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يدخر لكم هذه الكلمات الطيبة خالصة لكم يوم نلقاه. ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن تجد منا آذانا صاغية وقلوبا واعية وأن ينفع الله بها المتكلم والسامع.
آمين.
وجزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم.
حياكم الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
عليك السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. We would like to thank you. Alhamdulillah. And this is Wallahi, subhanallah wa ta'ala, this is what we need. We need to something like this to keep us focused. Because sometimes we are guided, but we don't think about this thing. We take it for granted. And we keep talking about something else and this. And some of us, through their statements and actions, things like they already made it. They already been in Jannah. They just came to check somebody or to visit somebody. But we have to check ourselves. This is a ni'mah. Subhanallah, in a trip, the previous, this last trip in Hajj, that's what was this mashayikh they were talking about. Sheikh Rabi', Sheikh Salih al-Suhaymi, Sheikh Ubaid, Sheikh Abdul al-Bukhari, the Sheikh himself, he gave us a talk, and many others. They constantly talking about this. Talking about to be mindful of the ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conferred upon us. And they said to us, especially you, that you live in a land of kufr. Look at yourself. Look at the percentage of the Muslims in that land. And also look at the percentage of the Muslims amongst those who are guided to the sunnah and to the understanding of the Salaf al-Salih. You find yourself that you're only a minority. So therefore he will make you think and ask yourself a question. Subhanallah, I'm guided through all these people. You may be the only one walking amongst 10,000 people. None of them is guided. You're the only one guided. Thank Allah just for that. Thank Allah that He made you guided. How many of us we know that you're the only one guiding your whole family? Nobody's in your whole family that live in the East and the West. Nobody's guided but you. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. Sometimes you may be the only Muslim in a whole neighborhood.
This audio file has been distributed by SalafiTapes.com. For more information, please contact us at info@SalafiTapes.com or visit us on our website www.SalafiTapes.com.